Even before the season has started, the word consistency has started cropping up in conversations about Bath rugby. It was one of the team's downfalls last season. The never-ending injury list played a significant part in that, and it's something the coaches are striving to eradicate for the coming campaign. While there have been areas of strength in the three warm-up matches this month, Bath have drifted in and out of the contests, and Leinster away was no different. They trailed 150 early in the second half and ended up going down 2,517. Toby Booth, WASNT Downbeat, though. In his eyes, the deficiencies will focus the minds for the much tougher challenge of Leicester Tigers at Welford Road in the Premiership next Sunday. Bath rugby forwards coach Toby Booth, Imajar Tor Lesniak, the forwards coach, said the level of opposition was probably more consistent against us today. I also think we were more inconsistent, which is obviously something we've been working on not being. We've travelled on the day and there are various bits and pieces where we need to be more resilient. Irrespective of the result, it's been a very good test for us. We will certainly be focusing on the questions around consistency and what we need to do when we're on the road, not just for Welford Road next week, but for us as a group and to grow as a group. If we have to take half a step backwards to come forward again, that's great. James Phillips carries hard against Leinster image. Patrick Arch, Fonside images. It's the latest in a long line of defeats on artificial pitches for Bath, to go with Saracens, Worcester Warriors, Cardiff Blues and Newcastle Falcons last season. When the Chronicle raised the issue, Booth said, "IWASNT particularly making that connection until you mentioned it, but we can throw that into the mix from a discussion point of view. Often it's more about how you execute. Some of the things we did well were great, we just need to do more of them." Daniel Evans, Ben Teo to Bath rugby is not as unlikely as you might think. Freddie Burns made his debut and Taulupe Faletau returned to action after his post-Lions break. Burns cut his head and went off for treatment, but there was no repeat of the concussions he suffered last season and he should be fine for the clash against his old club. Freddie Burns slings out a pass on his Bath rugby debut. Image. Patrick Arch, Fionside images. It's good to see everyone out there, getting them up and running and playing, Booth added. You can't expect people to be at their very peak, but they're quality players and the more quality players we've got on the pitch, the more chances we've got. They provide leadership and all the other things we know they'll deliver. We saw some really nice stuff from Freddie and Reese Priestland as well. The Bath Rugby web chat with Daniel Evans, August 25, 2017. It's really good for us that those boys are finding a bit of form. Toby Faletau and Kaan Focholi the same. He was very influential when he came on. Kaan Focholi bosses the forwards against Leinster image. Patrick Arch, Fionside images. Looking at the pre-season fixtures as a whole, Booth is pleased with the consistently high-quality line-out and how the starting front-row unit of Nick Autorat, Jack Walker and Kane Palmer-Newport have performed together. One player who has had his fair share of game time but might not have expected it is academy prop Sam Nixon. The farmer from Plymouth signed earlier this year primarily as a loose head, but with Henry, Thomas Knee and Max Lahief hamstring still out, and Sean Knight suffering a neck injury in training, he has been drafted in as a tight head replacement three games running. It's good because you're going to need these types of people throughout the season, Booth said. Elliot Stuke takes a line out as the sun goes down in Dublin. Image. Patrick Arch, Fionside images. Sam's obviously learning his trade on both sides of the scrum. We're not going to pigeonhole him as one or the other, but part of his development is learning both sides and what the differences are. Being the farmer that he is, he's an exceptionally strong young man. When he's been found wanting a little bit with some of the positions he finds himself in, he's been very tough and strong. He'll only get better with the exposure. The more he plays and gets roughed up a little bit, the better he'll become.